This afternoon, Missouri Lieutenant Governor Peter Kinder says that as the state's official advocate for Missouri seniors, he wants Missouri to join other states challenging the new law in court. Kansas is also trying to take on the health care law. KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney reports on what's next. Micheal?
Well, Larry, both Kansas and Missouri want to opt out of the health reform law that was passed and signed by the president today. As you just heard, Missouri may try to do it through a legal lawsuit with some other states, and Kansas is trying to pass a state constitutional amendment. So it looks like health care reform may have to go through the courtroom to get to the exam room.
And it's time for us to rise up and overturn this because we love freedom.
All but a handful of states have some sort of legal or legislative challenge to the health care bill underway, including Kansas and Missouri. This man, Kansas City area Dr. Milton Wolf, a distant relative of President Obama, wants the Kansas Constitution amended to block the requirement that everybody have insurance.
But for the first time in American history, we're being told you must purchase this from a private company just because you were born, just because you're alive. Now, a lot of constitutional scholars are going to say that's simply not constitutional.
But a UMKC law professor thinks that the courts would rule opting out of the health care plan is blocking interstate commerce, and that's regulated by the federal government.
By choosing not to participate in the commercial sale of the product, you affect the supply, you affect the demand, you therefore affect the price. You essentially, your activities can substantially affect interstate commerce.
And some others cite the 10th Amendment as a potential health care legal battleground. Now, the 10th Amendment says rights not designated to Washington are left to the states. But some conservative legal scholars think that the federal government has won so many 10th Amendment cases, there's too much legal precedent to overcome. And in Johnson County today, Tiart, who's running for the U.S. Senate, urged Republicans to overturn the law, but concedes it'll be tough.
Will this survive the court battles? I don't know. I don't think so.
Now, that Kansas vote on the constitutional amendment proposal is set for a Thursday vote. It needs a two-thirds majority from the House to proceed, and right now it doesn't have it. They're short that vote. And in Missouri, there is also a bill that would permit Missouri to opt out of the health care law. That's making its way through the legislature. As both here in Kansas and Missouri, there are challenges underway to the health care law, as there are now in so many states. Back to you.
Micheal Mahoney live. Thank you very much, Micheal. One other remote possibility to challenge the law would be to have two-thirds of the states call for a constitutional convention to amend the U.S. Constitution.